Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to talk about bar chart and column charts in Power BI. This is part of Visuals with Nags series, where I didn't cover this basic visual. That's why I thought of covering it in this series now. So to begin with, whatever you see here, if the bars are at the horizontally present, then it is called a bar chart. And when the bars are vertically arranged, it's called a column chart. And there are other types of charts along with this in the Power BI or any other reporting tool. There is stack bar chart and stack column chart, 100% stack, 100% stack column chart. All other things we will see as part of this video, when to use it. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. I use AdventureWorks database, so you can also use to follow this video and practice. So let's begin with the clustered column chart. The names are a little tricky, you know. It's tongue twister kind of. So clustered column chart, where you can analyze your measures, like from the sales amount, and then you can analyze with any of the categorical value. Let's consider product category. And let me increase the value slightly. Let's go for 16 so that everyone can view it. So from the initial glitch itself, you can able to understand the bikes are the most selling products. And I don't think any difference between a clustered bar chart and column chart apart from the orientation. Like the column chart appears over here and your clustered bar chart appears in the over here. The bars are appearing horizontally. So this is the core difference, and it may be in some business scenarios they have some criteria, some charts or some metrics should be shown like bar charts and some metrics should be shown in column charts, you know. So that difference, the people interchangeably use column chart or bar chart. Mostly when technically or from the developer's perspective, we will use this column bar chart for some kind of space issues. When you do not fit here, we will switch over here and make it like this, you know. So this is how people will develop. And when you consider other key things about this bar chart, let's get rid of this x-axis. So we can go with hierarchy. Usually when you have your column chart along with your data over here, right, you can have a comparison. You can see now I'm analyzing by quarter for each year, each quarter. I want to compare the previous quarter. So I've written a simple measure over here. When I drag and drop this one, same period last year, I can able to compare the results. Like for 2020 quarter one, 2019 quarter one value will appear next to my bar in 2020 quarter one. See, 2019 quarter one value is 6769487. Here 2020 quarter one, this value will appear 6769487, which is nothing but same period last year. This is the value for 2020 quarter one sales amount. If you see the labels measures changes. So these kind of comparison is more effective when you use the column chart. Whereas when you analyze like this, it won't give very good comparison. Obviously, as I said, whether based on the space issues, people interchangeably use. All the functionalities remain same for the bar chart as well as the column chart. So this is one thing I want to highlight, like for comparison, people go for it. Then let's get rid of this. Then in the same quarter, I want to understand what are the best selling products. I mean, what products I sold. When I put it in a legend, you can see for each quarter, this legend use it to split within that categorical value. So if you see here, this is the 2009 quarter one, and this is the bikes value, and this is your components value. We can make it zoom, and then you can start comparing. So you can see from this diagram, the legend used to split each categorical value within it forms like a group. So this is what a legend is. Instead of keeping this in legend, you can also keep this category in a small multiples. What it will do, it will enhance or whatever you see in your visuals in a single or whole category. For each value in this category, it will have the its own separate charts, okay, which will be combined in a single chart over here. You see the bikes, components, accessories, everything combined as a individual charts. This is what a small multiples. The same chart, whatever you are looking here, will be multiplied for the number of members. That is what small multiples is. So these are the different options you have got for your column chart. The same options, right? Everything remains same for your bar chart as well. There's nothing much I can explain it here. Let's try to move on to understanding about stacked and 100% stacked. Let's start with stacked column chart. So here, as I said, the properties remain same, x-axis, y-axis. When you put in the legend, okay, the category, last time what happens in the column chart, within this category there are four bars, okay, but in the stacked column chart what will happen, the bar, the single bar remains, it will split, the total value will be split across your stack, meaning like instead of four bars, let us copy and show it to you. So top one is the stacked column chart and the bottom one is going to be the column chart. So this is the difference. So basically within that category you are seeing different legends in a separate bars. That is your column chart. It is strict clustered column chart. Everything will be shown in the column. But in the column chart you want to show the values as a stacked these categories. So this value on top of this, this value on top of this. If it becomes like this, then it becomes a stack. What is the insight you are getting out of this charts? Basically, from the looks of it, you can easily see this particular bikes, okay, contributes to you more. That is what you can able to figure it out easily. And from the stacked, if you see when you go for 100% stacked column chart, you can see now based on the total value over here, okay, you have different bars with the different proportion. I mean, this is low value. That's why it compared to 2019 quarter three, it is very smaller. When you go to 100% stacked column chart, you see all the values are presented in a percentage manner. So it will be like 100% out of 100%, what is your bikes contribution? Even with the value it will show, okay, but you see 100% stacked, so all the bars over here will be shown against 100%. Now to show the difference properly, let us have the stacked bar chart here, and the below I will go for stacked column chart. So this is the difference. This is stacked column chart and this is the stacked 100% stacked column chart. So this 100% stacked column chart will have the all the bars contribute to 100%, and in that 100% how much each category has been contributed. And whereas in this stacked column chart you have the actual proportions, that is actual values split across each categorical value. So this is the core differences based on the different comparison. You can go for different charts. This is what your column chart, and whatever I explained, it is same applicable to your bar charts. When I click on here, this remains same. my looks of it. So this is somewhat better understanding, or which will give you good look when you have something like recruitment analysis, or how many people out of 1,000 people, how many of them passed, how many of them failed. So those kind of analysis you can make based on the different interviews happen. So it depends upon your business need. You will choose either of your bar or column charts. And bar charts and column charts are more or less same, only except with the directions. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.